Are you stressed by the big Rona from 2020, which has literally caged you in your home and turned you into a domesticated animal where days are going at your network speed and along with the regular power cuts, which is turning you into a machine, losing the sense of time and emotion in the never-ending horizon of work? You know what? You deserve a holiday, a vacation. We at Wisdom Destinations shall provide you with the best location to chill your processor and update you with non-buggy, stay-always-at-peace software before you overclock with your regular life. We use state-of-the-art technology to choose the perfect location for your vacation, which is pick a name out of the bowl.
Svalbard.
Svalbard is an archipelago which was discovered by the Dutch explorer Willem Barents in 1596. It is the world's northernmost urban community, is a part of the Kingdom of Norway, and is located in the Arctic Ocean, midway between the northernmost coast of Norway and the North Pole. With just a 3-hour flight away from Oslo, is a community of 3,000 people, and with landscapes dominated by tundra, bare mountains, glaciers, extreme light variations around the year. During winter, the temperature ranges from minus 13 to minus 20 degrees Celsius, whereas the average temperature in Svalbard is about 3 to 7 degrees Celsius, which allows you to do some fun activities such as boat trips, dog sledding, hiking, skiing, fishing trips, kayaking, horse activity, or arm wrestling with polar bears. Or if you are one of those people who like sightseeing rather than activities, then there are museums, galleries, coal mines, and some more polar bears and other wonderful animals to be at your service while you take your walk or snowmobile. By witnessing such a place, along with the friendly people and climate and nature and whatnot, I'm very sure you might get an idea why not relocate to this very place. And yes, you can. Svalbard might be part of Norway, but thanks to the Svalbard Treaty, that is, which recognizes the sovereignty of Norway over the archipelago of Svalbard, but it is a free economic zone and a visa-free zone, hence relocating to Svalbard is very easy and possible. Depending on how you travel, for example, if you decide to enter Svalbard through mainland Norway or the Schengen area, then you must have a double entry visa so that you can return to the mainland Norway or the Schengen area. But if you decide to swim all the way, you must bring your passport and ID cards as identity control is performed for all. Although you may live and work in Svalbard indefinitely, regardless of country and citizenship and work permit and whatnot, you are advised to obtain work and housing before you reach the destination, and the governor of Svalbard cannot arrange any work placements for you. And in simple terms, you are on your own and you have to contact various employers in the biggest town on the island, Longyearbyen, directly. With the high cost of living and most of the housing is owned by various employers who offer them to employees as a part of the employment, and it's very hard to get housing if you don't have a job. The Norwegian state owns practically all the land in Svalbard, and it is impossible to buy a plot for building your home, and some private housing has been built on rented land and the prices are astronomical. Since it is a protected zone, the rules and regulations are pretty strict and there is so much more to see. So, it's completely left to you whether you want to cleanse your mind or immerse yourself into nature and be one among the northernmost communities on the planet, along with those armored polar bears guarding the seed vault. We await your arrival.